Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube. So today I'm going to be filming an upper body session. It's been quite a while since I filmed one. I think I filmed one last year when I first came back onto YouTube post show. So I'm running an upper body split that Callum has set me. Through the session I'll be going over some tips and general shit really. So enjoy watching me and I'll catch you in a bit. Okay, so with line cuff lateral raises, what you want to focus on is literally pushing your hands backwards and almost like, imagine you're trying to touch the walls. Same with dumbbell laterals as well. Just imagine you're trying to like touch the side walls. Okay, and really like, I find with this exercise, either having my hands straight like this or my hands fisted makes a really, really big difference. You want to start with your hands with a little gap between each other. It always gets stuck, not like that. And then just here, just think about pushing your hands to the side of the walls. Slight pause. Don't let your hands cross over. A lot of people let their hands do that. Don't do that. Keep this gap the whole time. Push and nice and controlled down. Slight pause, reset, drive. Just going for partials. Fucking hell, Ali, what the fuck is this you're playing? So I was messaging Ali, the owner of the gym, to tell him to change the music. What I say goes in this gym. I'm the queen of the gym, he said, so there we go. Change the music, bitch. So at the moment, I am running one upper split with delts at the end of one of my lowers. So I've got to the point now where I'm basically kind of there in my upper. Obviously like for wellness, you do need some really sort of nice cap delts. So keeping them in is really, really important. But at the moment, it's just like maintaining my upper really. We don't need to be looked to kind of growing at huge amounts. Obviously I've got my boob job coming up as well. So I've got to consider all the time off recovering and then post that as well. I'm not going to be able to start training again, I can't train upper probably for quite some time. So I'm probably not going to be able to touch my upper for quite a few months. So if I can get some good fullness in it now and some good size, I know it's going to come down during my recovery, but that's kind of, my thought process as well. So when looking to build your physique, it's so important to be training hard. Okay, so I have a lot of questions on Instagram, like, Chloe, like, how do you grow as much as you do? Like, how do I grow more muscle? How do I get big legs? You need to just learn to push yourself to failure and get yourself or take yourself there. So you'll see a lot of people in the gym, they'll like just do their movement and they'll just like stop like with reps in reserve. It's fine if you're training in that style, but most people train to failure. You want to be going to a point where you cannot go anymore. Like you literally can't lift anymore. You're at the bottom of that shoulder press, like, fuck, I can't go. Not stop, like just like be really like chilled after. You should be buried, okay? So the way you need to be training is to complete failure, be in your set, don't look around, be focused like in that set and going and pushing yourself to failure on every single set that you do in the gym, whether that's a top set, back off set. Don't see a back off set as a set that's lighter, that's easier. It shouldn't be, it's still challenging because you're still going to failure.
6 to 9.
Yeah. Also, when you're doing a shoulder press, own that negative. So when you failed at the top, sorry, I'm fatigued now, don't just like slam it down, control it all the way down till you finish. Oh, that machine is so hot. So, in my check-in on Sunday, I hit a new high for my off-season this year. So I'm actually, it was like 73.4, I believe. I think so, anyway. Basically, just over 73. When I started my prep last year, I was actually 74. My body composition compared to when I was 74 last year, worlds apart. I know when I hit 74 this year, I will look still so much better. I'm holding less body fat, I've got more muscle, and it's because my reverse diet or my reverse phase post-show was pretty much perfect. That goes to show the importance of that post-show period. You know, if I gained a shit ton of body fat that I didn't need, I would not be in a good position right now. And I've still trained really hard. I've been sensible in terms of like my food consumption, my off-plan meals. I've enjoyed, but I've not gone, you know, crazy. So yeah, I'm actually in really, really good position. I can feel that I'm heavier when I'm just walking around. Like, I just feel heavier on my feet, but it's not a bad thing. Like Cal said to me, Chloe, like, you're gonna feel at times like you have less muscle because you've got less definition, especially in my glute, like ham tie-in. Like when I had a glute ham tie-in and my adductors showed, like I felt like I was like growing, but now I'm at the point, I'll do my back shot and I'm like, oh my God, I feel like I look shit, but I don't. It's because I've got more body fat, and you have to push yourself to those places in an off season. And if you don't, you're just not gonna grow optimally. So there is that like fine line about putting on too much body fat, you know, for the sake of it, you don't need to do that. But still, you can't be like lean in an off season if you want to make some decent progress. Right, so I've noticed on Instagram and through people DMing me, etc., and obviously consultations with potential clients, one thing that comes up is people, when they're in a surplus and in a gaining phase, they will compare their calories to someone else's, and I'll be like, well, in order to gain muscle, I should be on 4,000 calories, 5,000 calories, because so-and-so is having that many calories. It's very person-dependent, okay? I know there's figure girls and probably wellness girls that are eating double my calories, but that doesn't mean that I have to have those calories because I'm performing well, I'm not gaining too fast, my digestion's good, my appetite's not fucked. Like, if you're eating like huge amounts of food, obviously your appetite's gonna stall at some point, but everyone is so different, okay? Obviously some people are taller, some people have got more muscle mass, some people have been training for longer, some people train more across the week, like people are doing different classes as well, different categories, like all these things like add up together. And at the end of the day, like comparing your calories to someone else's is like comparing your physique to someone else's. It's pointless. It literally is pointless. More calories does not always mean more muscle. You have to be smart. So I just wanted to kind of like put that point across to you guys, because it doesn't matter, you know, if so-and-so is eating that much calories in the gym. Who cares? It's all about you and your gen. Better. Still gets like this pressure on here. It's horrible. So with this lat pull down variation or pull down variation, I am focusing more on my rear delt and upper back. So normally the lat pull down, I'd obviously pull and drive my elbows into my hips. With this one, I'm almost like trying to hit my rear delts. I'm pulling down and abducting my elbows out. Don't judge me. If you see me in the gym doing this, don't think Chloe's doing a lat pull down wrong, because I'm not. I'm trying to hit my upper back. As much as I love bodybuilding, you've obviously got to fit into categories and fit a criteria. And for me, I am really enjoying training upper. And I know that, I wouldn't be able to train upper. Well, I can't train upper as much as I'd love to, because I've obviously got to have the more dominant lower body. So that's the kind of annoying thing about bodybuilding sometimes, is that I love training, but I have to train sometimes in a certain way in order for me to fit into that category. Although I love training legs, I do love training arms, but you can't go on a wellness stage with some wham arms, so just kind of, it does annoy me sometimes. I used to love doing push pull legs when I was a figure girl. I absolutely love that, and I do miss that, like having a push session and a pull session. I just love like upper body. So with this row variation, what you need to focus on is making sure, again, like every pull movement, elbow drive, it's elbow to hip. Don't allow your shoulder to elevate, okay? A lot of people will like elevate their shoulder, allow their shoulder blade to go really forwards, and they almost like fall through the movement. Make sure you're staying nice and strong in your core, chest nice and high, or just sat upright, and just driving that elbow. It shouldn't be through the shoulder. If it's through the shoulder, you're performing it wrong. Either your setup's wrong, your seat's too low, your hands are not in a good position, or you're just simply allowing it to go up and losing control. So you need to really think about that elbow drive the whole time and keep it locked in. Everything in the lat there, you shouldn't feel it anywhere else. I'm just finishing the session off with my favorite part, and that's arms. I have three sets of 10 to 15. So my arms are looking quite big, look. I think my arms have always been quite big from horse riding. Just love a big, thick, juicy arm on a girl. That sounds really wrong. So with these tricep extensions, what you want to focus on is keeping your elbow tight. So don't, when you're pulling, like you've got to imagine you've got a pin going through your elbows, and they're literally just fixing there, just fixing the whole way. And try not to use your wrist too much. A lot of people like bend their wrists in like that. Try not to do that too much. Just extend with the elbow as much as you can. Don't let them come forwards or back too much.
Yeah.
Ow. Fuck. It's done. Fucked. So guys, that is upper body done and dusted. Hopefully you enjoyed watching me train. Wellness girls do train upper as well, and we still train hard. Any questions you have, guys, you know, comment or message me on Instagram. As always, like, share, subscribe, and I'll catch you on the next video.